Hello students. So again we are here with some questions to discuss, and these are again questions based on substitution unimolecular reaction, which we were discussing from like last 2-3 lectures. So this question is about determining rate of reaction with particular nucleophile. So what we are doing is we are comparing rate of SN1 reaction basically, because the question is rate with ethanol. Although the question was very large, which was in the textbook, but I have sorted it down with rate with ethanol. The question is rate of solvolysis with ethanol will be more rapid for which of the two, means which of the compound for given questions. Like in this sequence, this is the first question, so they are asking which one of these two will have higher rate of reaction with ethanol. So as we have discussed that rate of reaction of for SN1 reaction is determined by stability of carbocation formed after removal of leaving group. I would also like to stress this point that you don't have to think about the final rearranged carbocation. To determine rate of reaction, you have to compare stability of the first carbocation formed in each of the reaction, not the final rearranged carbocation, because the slowest step is ionization step, and the carbocation which is being formed by slowest step is the first carbocation, not the rearranged carbocation that is formed due to several rearrangement steps. So those are different steps. So what you have to focus on is first carbocation form. So it becomes very easy for you to identify or determine. What you will do, you will remove leaving group from all the positions and form a carbocation and check the stability of carbocation between these two pairs and compare which one will be more stable. The one which will be more stable will give higher rate of reaction than the one which is less stable. So let's start. This is our leaving group. We will remove the leaving group and form the carbocation. And if I expand this structure, it is basically two ethyl groups attached at this CH. So CH2, CH3. This is the actual compound, right? So it has two alpha hydrogen at this position and two alpha hydrogens at this position. So it has total four alpha hydrogen atoms. Why we are comparing alpha hydrogens? Because the most priority is given to aromaticity, resonance. So there is no aromatic compound in these two. Obviously, the carbocation is not aromatic due to obvious reasons, and it doesn't have resonance also because there is no any conjugation. So then ultimately we'll move to hyperconjugation. If it doesn't have hyperconjugation also, then we'll move to inductive effect. But commonly hyperconjugation will give you the result. Now this again is, if we expand this structure, this will be a carbon with 3 CH3 atoms, and once chlorine is removed, carbocation will be formed at this position. So this carbocation has 9 alpha hydrogen atoms, and this carbocation earlier one has only 4 alpha hydrogen atoms. So this one will be more stable. So second will give faster rate than first. If we name this as first, these are all first compounds and these are all second compounds of the given question. So second will have higher rate than first because second is more stable carbocation because it has more number of alpha hydrogens as compared to the first one. Let's move to the next question. In this next question, again we will remove the leaving group and form carbocation. We are not bothered about rearranging them because rate will be determined by first carbocation form, not by the rearranged carbocation, because in this case rearrangement will also take place. So we are not bothered about that thing by comparing rate of reaction. So again, this carbocation has 2 alpha hydrogen on this position and 1 alpha hydrogen at this position, right? So it has total 3 alpha hydrogen atoms. This carbocation has 3 alpha hydrogen over here, 3 over here, and 2 alpha hydrogen over here. So it has total 8 alpha hydrogen atoms. So now you know this one is more stable than this carbocation. So again, rate of second carbocation or rate of second substrate will be faster than first substrate when they react with ethanol. Now third question. Third question, we will have carbocation at this position, and in this case carbocation will be at this position. Now if we talk about this carbocation, it is on a carbon which is sp2 hybridized, and this is on a carbon which is sp hybridized. Why? Because it has two sigma bonds and one pi bond, and there is no any third bond. So it has two sigma bonds, so there will be only two hybrid orbitals involved in hybridization, and those hybrid orbitals will be one s and one p orbitals. On the mixture of those two orbitals, two different hybrid orbitals will be formed. So hybridization of this carbon is sp, hybridization of this carbon is sp2. Now you tell me which one of these will have higher electronegativity. Obviously sp carbon will have higher electronegativity than sp2, because as percentage s character increases, electronegativity increases. So percentage s character in sp is 50%, and that in sp2 is 33.3%. So it has more percentage s character, so it has more electronegativity. Now the next question: stability of positive charge is more on option number A, higher electronegative element, or low electronegative atom. So the answer is, stability of positive charge is more on low electronegative atoms, just like metals will be more stable with positive charge because their electronegativity is less. Similarly, non-metals will be more stable with negative charge because their electronegativity is very high. So positive charge will be more stable with element of lower electronegativity. Now in this case, element is same, but their electronegativity is varying due to hybridization. So this positive cation is more stable than this positive cation. So rate of substitution reaction will be given by this carbon faster as compared to this one. So first is greater than second, right? And then the last question, again we will remove the leaving group and form the carbocation. Now this is a very tricky question, and this is a very confusing question also, because what students think, that I will make you understand first. Students think that this carbocation has resonance, which is quite evident because there is a conjugation, so this will participate in resonance. And according to few students' point of view, oxygen has minus I effect, so it will pull electron density from a deficient carbon atom. So what oxygen is doing is, it is pulling electron density from deficient carbon atom, which is true. So according to that logic, this will be stabilized due to resonance, and this will get destabilized due to pulling of electron density, because it is already electron deficient, but oxygen will pull electron density, then it will make it more deficient. So the stability will decrease, but that is not the correct answer. Why? Because we are forgetting one important factor, which is plus M effect, or we can also say back bonding offered by this oxygen lone pair. Because oxygen has extra electron density, carbon has deficiency. So what oxygen will do is, oxygen will donate its lone pair to vacant orbital of carbon, and they will form a coordinate pi bond, which is also called back bonding. Or you can also call it resonance effect, and that is positive resonance effect, plus M. In some cases it is plus M. So actually this will be more stable than this one because of additional factor, which is back bonding. So second carbon is more stable than first carbocation. It means rate of second will be higher than rate of first when they get participate in solvolysis with ethanol. So I think this will clarify your doubts or clarify your concept on how to check rate of SN1 reaction with different substituents. Even if you have any doubts, you can post them in comment section below. You can like to the channel, subscribe to the channel, and share it with your